Executive, Rural Finance, L&D Financial Services. Thiru Vijay Bhai, Chairman, Arabindo Society. And Thirumati Dr. Nachiar, Director, Sri Arabindo Society. Distinguished guests, colleagues from L&D Financial Services here, members from Sri Arabindo Society, digital sakis who are all here, members of media, ladies and gentlemen. It's my proud privilege to extend the heartiest welcome to you all for the launch of Digital Sakhi program, Tamil Nadu. We feel extremely honored to have Hon’ble Governor of Tamil Nadu, Shri Banwarilal Purohit, today. And he's here in spite of his busy schedule. It's a matter of pleasure to, you know, have my other colleagues and people from Aurobindo Society here. As a good corporate citizen, L&D Financial Services are as we first started this program in Maharashtra. This was in continuation of what the government at that point of time wanted people to do in terms of financial transactions through digital mode, etc. And so we thought that we should play a part in ensuring that this is taken forward. Also, Digital Sakhi program focuses on sustainable development goals for gender equality. This program is already creating huge gains across the various states where we are present in, that is Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh. The program received an overwhelming response across 30 villages in Maharashtra since inception. Since then, these villages have seen 36% increase in the use of digital modes since we started this initiative in 2017. Also, digital modes of payment have increased significantly by almost about 27% of the households. Sorry, before we started, only 27% of the households used digital modes of payments. After 1 year of our implementation, it has increased to almost 63%. The second leg of Digital Sakhi program is also, apart from financial inclusion, identifying and upskilling the women entrepreneurs. The trades that these women are involved are precisely dairy, goatry, poultry, and other areas where women are interested. Results from our intervention with these women entrepreneurs indicated a 14.08% increase in their annual revenues across Maharashtra. Also, before we initiate any program, we do a baseline study and need assessment. This not only helps us to understand the community's socio-economic conditions, and exposure to technology also create a customized training module. The baseline and needs assessment survey of nearly 1,050 households in Vilupuram was concluded before we are now inaugurating and starting the program. The study revealed that all 99% of the household had bank accounts in Vilupuram district. But they were rarely operated, which is what is true across the country. While people had debit cards, the usage was very low. Also, awareness and adoption of digital modes of payment such as internet banking, mobile banking Aadhaar-enabled payment system and USSD are very, very low in Thillupuram. Additionally, by the penetration of mobile phones is high in the region. Only about 50% of the households are aware of the internet services. The findings clearly show the need to focus more on adoption of digital modes of payments. We hope through the Digital Sakhi program, we enable and encourage women in Tamil Nadu too. Our best wishes to each of the Digital Sakhis who are present here in taking the digital financial inclusion forward in Thillupuram. Once again, I express my sincere thanks to Hon’ble Governor Shri Banwarilal Ji Purohit for gracing this occasion with his presence and other respected guests on the dais. I now invite the Hon’ble Governor Banwarilal Ji to please come and light the lamp and inaugurate the program.
Hiru Sunil Prabhune to felicitate the governor with a small momentum. Hiru Manoj Sharma to hand over a CSR coffee table book which covers various CSR initiatives of L&T Financial Services and a white paper which is a culmination of our learning from Digital Sakhi program at Maharashtra L&T. Now I request Hiru Vijay to hand over a token of appreciation to the Honorable Governor. You all, videos are the best and the easiest way to understand what is being said and what is being done.
இன்னும் மக்களுக்கு பணம் கிடைக்கிறது இல்ல.
நான் படிப்பு முடிச்சு எம்ஏ பட்டம் வாங்கியிருக்கேன். இருந்தும் டிஜிட்டல் பேமெண்ட்ஸ் நான் எப்பவுமே பயன்படுத்தினது இல்ல.
We realized that this rural economy is largely cash driven. In line with the government's initiative to create a cashless economy, we started this initiative of
Tamil Nadu. Thiru Banwarilal Purohit. Respected colleague, Manoj Shenoy, Chief Executive and Group Head CSR. Respected Vijay Bhai, Chairman Sri Aurobindo Society. Tirumati Dr. Nachiyar, Director Sri Aurobindo Society. Distinguished guests, colleagues from L&T Financial Services, members of Sri Aurobindo Society, representatives of the media, very special participants in the program today, the Digital Sakhis. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to be amongst this august gathering today on this special occasion of launch of the Digital Sakhi in Tamil Nadu. We live in exciting times. Aadhaar has given universally recognized identity to every single Indian. Pradhan Mantri Jandan Yojana has given access to a bank account to every single Indian. Bheem has brought digital transactions within the reach of each one of us, and direct benefit transfers are helping ensure that every rupee of benefit reaches its intended beneficiary. Indeed, a digital revolution is upon us, and indeed, our India is transforming into our digital India. Given this context, need of the hour is obvious. How do we ensure that every Indian gets included in this dream of digital India? How do we ensure that our digital India does not remain a preserve of the privileged few in urban educated segment of our society? To achieve that, we need to ensure that every Indian masters the new language of this digital world that we are entering. We need to ensure all over again that we make every one of us, every one of our compatriots, literate. Literate not in the sense of being able to read or write, but literate in the sense that each one of us is able to master the tools required to use digital financial mechanisms that enable us to participate in this new world of today. Ladies and gentlemen, at L&T Financial Services, we serve over 80 lakh customers across the country. Predominant majority of them are in rural India, and predominant majority of them, more than 60 lakh, are women. For us, the answer to this particular conundrum is very obvious. The answer lies in firmly resolving that digital financial inclusion has to start with rural women. We educate the woman of the house, we educate the entire household. We make the woman of the house digitally financially literate, and we ensure financial inclusion of the entire family. We seek to achieve this through the program of Digital Sakhi. We seek to train rural women in the use of digital financial services using their mobile phone. We also seek to upskill rural women entrepreneurs so that they can take full advantage of this digital ecosystem that is being created. What we started 2 years back with a handful of digital sakhis in a few villages has now become a program that touches more than 1.5 lakh of our compatriots. And this is just the beginning. In many ways, Digital Sakhi is an expression of our core belief at L&T Group that as Indian citizens and as an Indian corporate, we are not mere beneficiaries of the ecosystem of our country. It is our duty, is our attempt to make a humble contribution towards making Digital India a reality. We are grateful to the Honorable Governor for his valuable time. We thank all the dignitaries and guests who have come here to grace the occasion. And on this occasion, we seek blessings and support of each one of you to make Digital Sakhi initiative a success in the state of Tamil Nadu. Thank you. Jai Hind.
On the dais, in the hall, and most important, all of you here who are going to make the Digital Sakhi program a success. I'm really happy and honored to be part of this launch of the Digital Sakhi program. Banwarilal ji, it was exactly 1 year ago that you were with us at the Sarvam villages at Vilipuram. And it was such a great encouragement for the Sarvam team and especially for the village community. We are indeed happy that today you have again taken out the time to be with us in this midst of your schedule. And you can see how many of them recognize you and how happy they are to have you with us. We are indeed grateful. For us in Sri Aurobindo Society, it is a great joy to work with the L&T Financial Services team. It is a beautiful collaborative partnership that we have, and we hope together that we will create a new model of digital financial literacy for India. India is passing through momentous times, and great unimaginable changes are sweeping across the country. A new forward-looking government is in place. A very significant date is coming, 15th August 2022. It is the 75th anniversary of India's independence, and the same date is the 150th birth anniversary of Sri Aurobindo. We would like this program of Digital Sakhi to be our offering for the new India which is arising. This program is not meant to be one more digital financial program. We hope to bring in innovative ideas and approaches from the community and, most important, from the women Digital Sakhis themselves. We believe and hope they will not just be implementation partners. We have the faith and the confidence that they have the capacity to contribute in conceptualizing the program, in creating the strategy, so that it is not just a digital program, it is not just an economic program and development program. It is a program for social change based on the deeper spiritual values and culture of India. And I believe very, very strongly, with our past experience, that all of the persons sitting here and everywhere will have a lot to contribute at every level in it. I have great hopes from this program because it is meant to be a model not only for Tamil Nadu, but for the whole of India. And in this effort, I invoke the divine grace and blessings on all. This is not the time to give long talks. It is the time for action. And to end, I hope that this program will be full of enthusiasm. Technology is not necessarily connected always with enthusiasm and joy and harmony. How do we bring these into it? And one of the ways that harmony expresses itself is through music. So, Richa, may I request you that when you give your vote of thanks, you will also sing for us before we sing the national anthem, so that we have music in this entire program. Thank you.
M. Lata. Thank you.
I request the guest on the dais for a group picture along with these five digital sakis. I request all the five digital sakis to come up the dais and have a... Thank you.
The movement, the financial services, Dr. B. Nachia, Director Sarvam, Shiru Manoj Sinai, Group Head, CSR, L&T Financial Services, distinguished invitees, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me great happiness to be here for the launch of Digital Sakhi program being organized by the Sri Aurobindo Society and L&T Financial Services. I am informed that this program is covered under the Sarvam project of the society and is an initiative aimed at integral development of villages, primary objective being the inclusive and sustainable development of rural areas. Starting with two villages in Puthurai and Perambai in Villupuram district of Tamil Nadu, Sarvam has now extended its operation to cover nearly 30,000 people living mostly in villages in and around Puducherry and Villupuram. Sarvam stands for Sri Aurobindo Rural and Village Action and Movement. Sarvam, S-A-R-V-M, Sri Aurobindo Rural and Village Action and Movement. As the name suggests, it reaches out to each and every individual in the community, irrespective of his or her caste, religion, age, economic and social status. This is the duty, crux. Activities such as evening tuition classes, scholarships for higher education programs meant for empowerment of women, medical camps and livelihood activities are being pursued under the Sarvam project. The Digital Sakhi program under the project combines women empowerment and digital financial literacy. It has been inspired by the desire to make use of the transformative nature of technology for empowering women, particularly in the low income groups. It speaks to build on the base created by the Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana and Aadhaar, under which access for banking and finance have been enabled for crores of underprivileged people at the bottom of the pyramid. For this digital financial literacy program, 50 digital sakhis and 50 digital champions have been selected from the villages of Villupuram district. The digital sakhis are being trained in fields such as digital literacy, financial literacy, leadership development, and communication skills by the digital champions who are college students who have been trained in the various technical aspects of online banking, IT-enabled financial applications. A total of 30 villages are proposed to be covered. Digital Sakhis and Digital Champions are to adopt door-to-door teaching methods in 20 primary villages, and in the remaining 10 villages, mass camps will be organized to educate people in digital financial literacy. Am I correct? The Aurobindo Society is being assisted in this novel mission by the L&T Financial Services. who have developed the teaching modules for training the digital champions and sakhis. The training given under the program will greatly benefit those women who are already part of self-help group, as its foundation and culture at this embellishment. I am sure that the digital sakhi program will be a roaring success and serve as a model for development for the whole of India. Here, one thing I would like to tell you, all of you. You always decide to lead a very, very simple life. Very simple. Mahatma Gandhi has told that God has given us everything for the need, but not for the greed. Why? Mahatma Gandhi is the example. There is such a very, very simple life. And always have faith in God. He is the supreme authority. Have faith in Him. You will succeed. All the obstacles will be removed. 101% I tell you, this is the Tamil. Any God. If you are Hindu, Ram, Vishnu, Krishna, any. If you are Christian, hymns of the Bible, you can remember and sing. If Muslim, then any verse of the Quran. While sleeping, thank God. Sleeping. Remembering that my Lord, because of your blessing, my today's day was the best. You will sign like your personality will develop. Lead a simple life, have faith in God, simple eating habit, no wife, nothing, nothing, nothing. You will sign. God will give you enough. And entire society will respect you. Society realizes always who is the God. If truthful life, simple living, hard work will sign like an end. I wish this Sri Aurobindo Society success in all its endeavors and appreciate them for having put into practice various innovations that have transferred life in the rural area. I also extend my best wishes to L&T and best wishes and greetings to all the villages who are working with the Sri Aurobindo Society to achieve greater economic development and prosperity in the state. Nandri Vanakkam, Jai Tamil Nadu, Jai.
This program in Maharashtra and MP and Odisha, and this is the launch of the Tamil Nadu project. We promise that we will be making this model sustainable by working on various collaborative models. And this program is in complete alignment with Government of India's Digital India campaign to build a digital infrastructure. We would like to thank our implementing partners, Sri Auro Society and Sarvam Singh, Vijay Bhai, Dr. Nachiyar, Senthil Chitra and their teams who have selected the digital sakhis in the region and will be working on the capacity building and enabling financial inclusion, reaching to close to 40,000 community members. We would like to thank our leadership, Mr. Manoj Chinoy and Mr. Sunil Prabhune for gracing us with their presence and guiding us time to time and adding value to our CSR programs. We would like to thank our friends from media houses who have come here and are covering their bet. We would like to thank internal teams, corporate communication, marketing and branding teams and facilities and channel management who have enabled us to put this event together. And lastly and most importantly, the digital sakhis and all the community members who have come all the way from Vilipuram and have made this event a success. I now request everyone to stand for the national anthem.
Request everyone else in the audience to be seated. Please do not move from your seats. Everyone in the audience to be
is an important occasion for us. As we spoke of in the August presence of the Honorable Governor, this was a program that we launched about 2 years back from very, very small beginnings. And through this journey of 2 years, This program has touched 1.5 lakh lives through educating individuals in use of digital financial tools and in upskilling rural women micro entrepreneurs to scale up their business aspirations. It is our pleasure and it is our pride to bring this program now to the state of Tamil Nadu. State of Tamil Nadu has been extremely important to us for all that we have done in the sphere of our business. This is a state where we serve lakhs of customers through more than 2,500 employees. So it's our pleasure, it's our privilege to contribute back to the ecosystem that we get so much out of. At L&T Group, at L&T Financial Services, we believe that we are not just a beneficiary of this ecosystem that our country offers to us. We, as Indian citizens and as an Indian corporate, have this duty to contribute back to strengthening of this ecosystem. Obviously, the time that we are in belongs to the digital revolution, to the mobile revolution, and it is our humble attempt to make sure that in this journey, in this transformation, nobody is left behind, that it truly becomes inclusive. Thank you so much for your support. Thank you so much for your presence, and we'll be very happy to answer any questions you may have. I think it is very, very important. If we take a pan-India view, the need that exists to create digital financial literacy is really very vast. Compared to that, our humble capabilities are definitely not adequate to serve all the needs that exist. As I mentioned a minute back, even after our concerted effort of 2 years, we have reached 1.5 lakh possible beneficiaries out of tens of crores that need this particular service. So effectively, any starting point for us is a good starting point. Having said that, our CSR team undertakes very scientific exercise in establishing the baseline need in the given community, and only when there is complete conviction that there is a real need and we can serve that need through our efforts, do we go in and opt for that particular geography. In this case, we look at it. Yes, you are right, sir. Potentially, there are several other districts across the state of Tamil Nadu and across our country for that matter, which can benefit from this program. And it is our aspiration that with time, we'll be able to expand our reach.
What is the selection criteria for selecting Sakhi, sir?
Clearly, our digital Sakhis, they are represented here. If we can please give them an applause. Best and the brightest of our community. Their ability to provide leadership through their actions. Clearly, there is an expectation that they will be able to dedicate significant part of their time in helping spread digital financial literacy. They will dedicate significant time in upskilling aspiring entrepreneurs. There is an expectation, apart from certain educational qualifications, that they do possess these leadership abilities, these technical abilities, these learning abilities, which can help them effectively lead the communities that they are part of.
Are they member of any NGO or individual people, sir?
They are individuals who are participating in this program with us, and we are proud to have them as partners in reaching this to the beneficiaries.
They are not part of any NGO or something?
As you know, in Tamil Nadu, we are partnering with Shri Aurobindo Society. They are in it as our partners, and we are together helping digital sakhis reach across to potentially thousands and lakhs of beneficiaries.
Any plans to have for men also? You are talking right, I'm just saying somewhere.
Your question may be on a lighter note, but on a serious note, the 80 lakh or so customers that we serve, you will be happy to note, sir, that predominant majority of them are actually women. These are women micro-entrepreneurs. And what you see is that you educate the woman of the household and the entire family's fortune changes. Entire family gets transformed. Not just the person herself, but the next generation suddenly becomes very, very different in terms of their future prospects. So we believe the need to start with the woman of the household is perhaps the most important. Our inclusion story will be real only when it reaches to the better halves in the family.
What exactly this digital Sakhi course covers? Because the AI
covers. One, through digital Sakhi program, we train women in rural parts of our country in the use of digital financial tools. How does one use the most effective invention that is breaking all hierarchies, which is the mobile phone? Reach across to various financial services that are today becoming available to us thanks to increased penetration of Aadhaar, availability of Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, availability of Bheem as the application to do digital transactions, and many, many more. So this is one part, training of women in rural India on use of these tools. Second part is imparting certain skills to rural micro entrepreneurs in helping scale up the businesses that we do, that they do, businesses that we indicatively mentioned, which are prevalent among the beneficiaries, are businesses like animal husbandry, are businesses like poultry or goatry, etc. The idea is that how do we strengthen the cause of women empowerment and digital financial literacy through this holistic program of digital.
Have they also taught about the vulnerabilities of digital
tools? Includes awareness of possible dangers and risks. It is very important that that is also a part of what is being imparted as understanding.
And Tamil Nadu is the third state to implement?
Sir, I think it is fourth state.
After Odisha.
After Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, and now Tamil Nadu.
You have also mentioned the target for the current financial year to expand to fifth state. What it could be? Five states?
Sir, there are various possible locations where we can actually expand. One thing we want to be sure about is that wherever we take this program, we are able to do justice. As I admitted a minute back, the need, the scope is very vast. It is actually how we can bring in the best of our resources to bear. So there are some potential states that we are considering, and we will of course come to you
the studies when going that. On.
It is, as I mentioned a while back in answering to our colleague here, that the process of establishing the need is very rigorous, very scientific, and we will follow that. Sir, the idea is always that can one digital Sakhi over a period of time reach across to 1,000 women and impart these skills and impart this knowledge. We are starting with a base of 50 digital Sakhis. So clearly the expectation is that over a period of time, each of them will end up touching 1,000 people. It's a multiple.